In this video, we will take a look at the concrete damage plasticity material model. We can find it in the Abaqos CAE user interface, in the property module, then go to Material Manager, create mechanical plasticity, and then we have here concrete damage plasticity. And then we have here different variables, the dilation angle, the eccentricity, then two ratios and the viscosity parameter. And then here the compressive and the tensile behavior. Okay, now let's start and look at each individual value. First off, we have here the dilation angle. So what is the dilation angle? The dilation angle is the angle of internal friction of the material. And we have here the hyperbolic Drucker-Prager flow potential function. And you can see it's a function in a diagram with an equivalent effective Mises stress and the hydrostatic pressure stress. And here in this function, we can here see the slope of the function and the angle. Here is the dilation angle. And it ranges from 30 to 40 degrees. Okay, next we have the eccentricity. And the eccentricity value can be seen here. It basically defines the rate at which the hyperbolic flow function approaches its asymptote. And the default value is 0.1. Okay, the next value is the ratio of FB0 to FC0. It's the ratio of the biaxial compressive yield stress to the uniaxial compressive yield stress. And the default ratio is 1.16. Okay, next we have the value K. And the value K is also a ratio. It's the ratio of the second stress invariant on the tensile meridian to that on the compressive meridian. You can see here the K value defines the shape of the yield surface in the deviatory plane. And if the ratio is 1, we have basically a circle. If the value K is about 0.67, it is more like a triangular shape. Okay, next we have the viscosity parameter. It's basically used for the material equations in Abaqos Standard and the default value is 0. Okay, next we have the compressive and the tensile behavior. So concrete is a brittle material, that means in general that the strain of fracture is less than 5%. And in this case we have a much higher compressive strength compared to the tensile strength. And here you can see an example. You can see here the stress strain curve and here for compression and here for tension. You see already that the magnitude of compression is like 10 times higher compared to tension. And then you see here the standard regions. We have first an elastic region, then a plastic region, and then a softening region. Tomorrow we will apply this concrete model to a buckling problem and work with it further. Okay, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching and until next time.